most versatile of the American fighters was the Phantom. It was the workhorse of Navy and Air Force, equally good at air combat or on a bombing run.
Smoke and Thunder Hog F-4 is one of the finest airplanes in the world. You know, an airplane is like your wife. She has her good points, her bad points. You love the good ones and you learn to live with the bad ones. The F-4 has got a lot of good points. And if I had my choice of flying a MiG-17, a MiG-19, or a MiG-21, I would rather fly the Phantom. She has 17,900 pounds of thrust per engine. Very reliable. It turns like a truck. She won't out-turn a MiG, but you know the good points of your weapon system. It outperforms and outclimbs the enemy. So you go vertical. Now, he can't go vertical with you.
I would have to say that the missile was the most frightening aspect. Flak is flak. They had more flak than the Germans had. It was deadlier. It was radar-guided. It shot down more people than the missiles did. But there's something terribly personally impersonal about being the target of an oncoming SAM missile. You know exactly how a fish feels in a barrel. That thing is coming at you. It means to kill you.
The first thing that you see is a large cloud of dust. And then there's some fire, there's some smoke, and you see a large projectile blasting out of it, just like a rocket launch. And then you determine who it's going for. It makes you feel a little better if it's going for one of your buddies. However, if it's coming for you, it doesn't make you feel so good, but it does rearrange your priorities.
The missile, quite frankly, was terrifying. Washington gauged the success of the missile upon those fired versus those that hit us, never appreciating the percentage of those fired that missed was very high because we were desperately avoiding being killed. Sometimes to the detriment of mission accomplishment. But more often, we did it with great skill and cunning and managed to complete the mission regardless. But when you've been shot at by 24 of those things in about a 3-minute period, as my flight and I were on one occasion, you find yourself right down on the deck, which is no place to be over North Vietnam, because even the school children were shooting at you. And the missiles did that. That didn't happen too often, but it happened often enough to make a Christian out of you if you were a pagan.
The withering anti-aircraft fire, a deadly mixture of flak batteries and SAM missiles, made attacking North Vietnamese targets a dangerous business. By the war's end, over 1,800 American aircraft had been destroyed by enemy action, 2,000 aircrew lost, and many pilots the prisoners of an unsympathetic enemy.
We knew how our people were being treated. And if you have an enemy that you can hate, it's much easier to go after him with venom in your fangs than it is for someone that you've never really had much to think about, then you're just fighting because of his differences.
During the years after World War II, technology advanced tremendously. People with many, many degrees climbed into their crystal palaces and their golden domes and forgot. The lessons of the past were forgotten. Much was driven by the superior knowledge and the ego of the designers. They didn't appreciate the use of fighters. They'd been thinking so long about nuke strike. What do you need a gun for? Oh, the Sidewinder will solve everything. He didn't put a gun on the F-4. I flew an entire year of combat without a gun on the F-4. I managed to shoot down 4 MiGs. But if I'd had a gun on that F-4, I say unequivocally, without any doubt in my mind, I could have shot down 9 more MiGs.
We went into Vietnam going full circle. The tactics that we used were antiquated. The weapons that we used were utilized to shoot down Russian bombers, not tight turning MiG 17s, 19s, or 21s. The pilots were not trained properly. We went in with reckless abandonment and got our socks knocked off. For a power like ours to go into a country like theirs and fight against their airplanes, we did very poorly.
U.S. military chiefs, responding to this and what they saw as the growing Soviet threat, set out to improve their tactics. The Navy introduced the Top Gun Weapons School, and the Air Force followed with its own answer, the Aggressor Squadrons.